Do you need more ideas on what bourbon to buy when you're out next? Or maybe you want to buy your bourbon buddy another bottle, but you're not quite sure what to get yet. Well, I've got five bourbons today that you should add to your collection or buy for that special whiskey friend. Let's get into them. Okay, first up is Henry McKenna 10-year, distilled by the prestigious Heaven Hill Distillery. 100 proof, 50% ABV. The mash bill on this is 78% corn, 12% malted barley, and 10% rye. It is very, very good. The only slight problem with this bottle, this is the only one that has that issue, is it's a slight allocation. They're not super, super hard to find, but they're not that common. Only downside to this bottle. But at 100 proof, it packs a lot of flavor. It drinks kind of like 110 proof. It is very rich and very spicy. The mouthfeel is a little more viscous. It's like medium bodied, it's not light. It is a really, really good daily drinker or a session dram. The finish is really nice. You get those standard cherry, caramel, brown sugar notes you get out of bourbons, but I think this one, if it was a little more available, would be one of the perfect daily sippers. The problem here again is there's a slight allocation, but if you find it, it should be around 60 bucks. I would not pay more than 65, but it is also single barrel, so you get those different flavors out of each release, which I really do enjoy. This is an ongoing release, so that's the first one, Henry McKenna 10 year. Okay, next up is Penelope Architect, distilled by MGP. It is 110 proof, 55% alcohol, and finished in French oak staves. Now this is a 4-grain mash bill, 75% corn, 15% wheat, 7% rye, and 3% malted barley. And spoiler alert, this is my favorite one of the five I have today. This is an incredible bottle. I think it's right now one of my favorite Penelope's actually just ever, but this is 55% alcohol, but it is just so rich, so thick. The mouthfeel is incredible. And the French oak, I know, kind of has like a divided line between people, whether they like it or not, but I really do enjoy it. The French oak brings a lot of vanilla, some cream, and a lot of nice cinnamon spice to the whiskey. So on top of the caramel, brown sugar, those maraschino cherry vibes, you get really nice, deeper creme brulee vanilla sweetness that sticks around really well in this finish. And I think it drinks a lot more than 110 proof, but it's not overbearing. 110 proof, but the finish makes it feel like it might be like 120, 125 proof. It's really chewy. It's really nice. It's really thick. It is really rich. I like this bottle. You can find this in most places. And I think the standard release, 104 proof. So this is a store pick at 110 proof, but it should be around 60 bucks. Do not pay more than 65 for this. You should be able to find them and pay that money for it. I think that is a absolutely incredible price point for this bottle. And that's number two, Penelope Architect. Okay, number three, Wild Turkey Rare Breed Barrel Proof. 116.8 proof, 58.4% alcohol. The mash bill on here is 75% corn, 13% rye, and 12% malted barley. So you have a nice middle ground there between the rye and the malted barley. So it's not too spicy, but it's not too sweet. I think this has a really, really good value to what's in the bottle ratio. It's around $50 to $55, which is great. A really, really perfect daily sipper. Even though it's 116 proof, I don't think it drinks that high. I think it tastes a little lighter and a little floral and a little fruitier than, say, the Architect, which is 3% less alcohol. I would say this probably tastes more like 52%, if I had to say. It has a little bit of a shorter finish, but it's a fantastic daily sipper. You don't feel bad when you pay 50 bucks for it and you can always find it, which is great to have in your collection. Wild Turkey is an incredible name in the bourbon world, so if you can get this for 50 bucks, do it. That's number three. Okay, number four, Knob Creek Single Barrel 9-year, coming in at 120 proof, 60% alcohol. This is the same mash bill as the Wild Turkey, 75% corn, 13% rye, and 12% malted barley. However, I think the distillate is a little more harsh, I would say, than the Wild Turkey. It's only 2% more alcohol, but it really, really is harsh and a little peppery. I just think the distillate has a little less of a good craft to it, and it definitely tastes, I would like to say, raw. However, if you're a Knob Creek fan, you can always find these, and they're definitely more available than the 12 or the 18. I just saw a picture today of the 18 for $270. No thank you. For 60 bucks, this is an incredible value. However, I've been really enjoying making cocktails out of this. I know out of that one video I made, that was a joke, by the way. However, this is a good cocktail whiskey. It's not gonna be great to drink neat or straight, but you can. It's just a little too harsh for my taste. It doesn't have that well-crafted distillate taste that I really enjoy. But there's number four, 60 bucks, Knob Creek. And last but not least, we have Larceny Barrel Proof, distilled by, again, Heaven Hill. Coming at 124.4 proof, 62.2% alcohol. Now, this one's the Batch B. It's not the Batch A124, which is highly allocated, so you're not going to find that. I think this is pretty dang good. I actually had a pour of the Batch A at a bar, and honestly, it wasn't like so much different than this one. I think this one is great. This one is around $70. Even though this is the highest proof of the five, I think it drinks less hot than the Knob Creek, for example. It definitely has a better crafted distillate because, you know, Heaven Hill, but it's definitely rich and it's smooth despite it being 124 proof. I enjoy that a lot. I like being able to have barrel proof whiskeys that don't like make me like burn my nose hairs out. If you're looking for a barrel proof whiskey, I think give this one a shot. It's only 70 bucks, and I think that was a store that kind of upcharged it a little bit for me. So it might even be less than $70. And it is a very, very good barrel proof. If you look at the Elijah Craig barrel proof, that's probably 90 to 100 bucks, depending on your store. The Old Forester barrel proof, another $100. This is $30 less, and I think it's pretty dang good if you want to compare the three. So why not grab this one for number five? Well, there's five bourbons that I highly recommend you go out and try if you haven't had one already. If I had to pick the one I recommend the most, it would be Penelope Architect. However, you have two single barrel options with the McKenna and the Knob Creek. You have two barrel proof options with the Larceny and the Wild Turkey, and you have a finished option with the Penelope Architect, which again, would be my favorite. All five are solid. All five are less than 70 bucks, which is great for value. And I think they're all really good. Obviously, I have all five. Like this video? Give it a like. Not subscribed yet? Make sure you do so you catch more videos like this and others every Wednesday. But until then, see you next time. Cheers.